And welcome to the 21st edition of Mavic's Maritime News. These are the headlines on Monday, 6th July 2020. Increased scrutiny of Chinese goods at the Indian ports explained. Vande Bharat mission increases flights. But is this too little, too late for seafarer transfers? Staffers of Indian ship manning companies grapple with increased restrictions in Mumbai. NUSI to hold webinar on corona-related issues. Why does Indian multimodal sector perform so poorly? AmTrak President Bhadkamkar dissects. And now, the news in detail. Recently, Indian media has reported that the custom authorities at some Indian ports have started conducting extra scrutiny of consignments that have arrived from China. Although Union Minister of India, Mr. Nitin Gadkari, has issued a statement that there is no arbitrary stopping of any goods at Indian ports. Mavic sought clarifications on this matter.
We stand with our brave hearts. We feel that Make in India, Made in India, Be Indian, Buy Indian is a strong movement and we all support it. Except what we feel is current holdup of consignment should not lead to container detention and increased ground rent. Because during lockdown, already the importers have suffered a lot. Contrary to popular belief, that there was some kind of unfair exemption on ground rent and detention charges. Our information is record amount of ground rent and container detention charges has been collected. So they should not be burdened by a new thing. Already the manufacturing sector is in stress and we all support that Indian should be done and there should be a different approach to this where better interaction rather than surprise. But we are still solidly with the government and our brave hearts in everything that is being done. And we also understand that not every time there can be a transparency, not every time the intentions can be expressed. So I don't belong to a school which says that everything should be known. In international diplomacy, in trade wars, secrecy is an important part and people who say otherwise, either they don't know what they are saying or their intentions are not, I would say, well placed.
From July 3rd, India's Vande Bharat mission of repatriating Indians back home entered the fourth stage of its operations that had begun in early May this year. India's private airlines like the SpiceJet, IndiGo and GoAir are likely to have a significant participation in the ongoing fourth phase. And the Indian national carrier Air India will connect leading airports of India with 17 countries by operating 96 flights. This news was greeted with great relief in Indian ship manning circles. But is this a case of too little, too late?
Continuous efforts are going on by ship owners, managers, organization authorities for crew changes. Steps taken so far, like chartered flights, deviation to Indian ports, have helped. But it's still a long way to go. Vande Bharat mission has entered phase 4. With growing number of seafarers unable to sign on and sign off, phase 4 should give considerable opportunity for crew changes and process around it has to be simple.
Amid a spike in the COVID-19 cases, Section 144 has been recently imposed in the shipping capital of India, Mumbai, till July 15th. This section prohibits the presence or movement of one or more persons in any public places or gatherings of any sort anywhere. How are the staffers of the Indian ship manning companies and seafarers grappling with this unprecedented situation that has also imposed a night curfew in Mumbai from 9 p.m. to 5 a.m.?
Gatherings of non-essential people may increase the infection rate, the imposition of Section 144 in Mumbai and surroundings is meant for the safety of people. As far as the emergency services are concerned, the people related with the emergency services are allowed to move for their work without restrictions, even in the night. In relation to seafarers, MHA has already issued guidelines for their sign-on, sign-off as per the request of Ministry of Shipping and the Directorate General of Shipping. Seafarers are being issued with e-passes for their movements in this regard. The government has extended all the possible support to our seafarers. In fact, the Directorate General of Shipping is working day and night to facilitate the seafarers in this COVID-19 situation.
We have a lot of challenges in putting people on the ship because of the lockdown across the world. India has also imposed night curfew and Section 144. Because of that, the movement is restricted for people within India. But for putting people on the vessel, we need to move our people across the length and breadth of the country to reach the airports so that they can join the ships. We as a company abide by the government regulations because it is for us to make sure the spread is not gone beyond control. But the DG Shipping and the government machinery is providing us support by way of allowing us to apply for travel passes, which is being used, and we as the shore staff and the people joining the ships are able to move across.
On Tuesday, 7th of July at 12 noon IST, the National Union of Seafarers of India, NUSI, is to hold a webinar to discuss the importance of well-being during the ongoing pandemic. MASA CEO Captain Shiv Halpe and NUSI Sahara Councillor Mrs. Prerna Bharadwaj will be the keynote speakers at this session to discuss the management strategies in combating stress and anxiety.
Positive Rahona, Corona Se Darona. Ye theme hai NUSI ka well-being webinar ka, jo kal, yani Tuesday 12 baje kal hone wala hai 7 tarikh. Hamara maksad, hamare seafarers और उनकी फैमिलीज को इंटरैक्टिव सेशन करने के लिए, जिसमें हमारे साथ कैप्टन हलवे साहब भी रहेंगे मासा के, एंड एक्सपर्ट गाइडेंस देने के लिए मिसेस प्रेरणा भारद्वाज, उनके साथ में मिलकर हम कुछ सीखेंगे कि इस कोरोना की स्थिति में हम हमारा आप को कैसा संभाले और आगे कैसा बढ़े. क्योंकि कोरोना कोरोना करके हम सिर्फ टोकरा लेके नहीं घूम सकते. वी हैव टू कॉम्बैट दैट, वी हैव टू काउंटर कोरोना एंड गेट ऑन विद आवर वाइज. दिस इज द थीम, दिस इज द पर्पस ऑफ टुमारोज नूसी वेबिनार. तो आप लोग सभी लोग नूसी वेबिनार पे आने की कोशिश कीजिए. जस्ट लॉग ऑन टू द नूसी फेसबुक पेज लाइव.
In a Marex exclusive with its executive editor Hemang Pala, the president of Association of Multimodal Transport Operators of India, AMTOI, Mr. Shantanu Bhatkamkar, spoke about the problems of multimodalism in our country. Bhatkamkar dissects the various issues that plagues the sector and how these are quite unique to India.
Atmanirbharta as Prime Minister and government desires is a welcome move But before they touch and encourage the entrepreneurs and logistics professionals, I think the government itself should have greater clarity on this issue. So this issue, government should study for better understanding that it should have on this issue. Logistics constitutes 14% of the GDP is a well-known statement. We hear it so many times and it almost seems to be a taunt to us. But then logistics cost, the way it is computed, I am not saying it is wrong, but the basis is it's a percentage of cost. So if you compare with a high cost economy, which is manufacturing Boeing and selling software, and selling iPad and their mobile phones, and compared to logistics cost of fruits and vegetables, this approach doesn't work well. This is a mixture of apples and oranges along with carrots and cabbages and spices and salt. So you won't be able to distinguish taste of one from other and what is not right and what is not in right proportion. For that, we have to adopt a method of end-to-end. And just take a small example, when we say it is 14%, and we all know that 52% of GDP is service sector. So this burden is on 48%. So we are effectively saying 29% is the logistics cost of goods manufactured and the agriculture produced. So essentially what it covers is damaged fruits and vegetables because of bad packing, inventory carrying cost, dead inventory, interest on inventory, and so many other things, which is nothing to do with transport cost. Now, even if we take transport cost, for example, the transport cost is about trucking, if you take. Now, the elements of this transport cost largely comprises of taxes, largely comprises of tolls. Now, if we are serious about bringing that cost, then we have to look, take a look at tolls and taxes on the capital goods, taxes on the diesel and spares, tires, everything. Secondly, we also have to take a look at how much time Indian trucks spend in the factories of customers in idling. In Europe, in America, and even in Far East, Southeast Asia, Middle East, normal window available for loading or unloading, as the case may be, to a customer is 2 hours. In America, they are trying to break it down to 1 hour. And anything about that is supposed to high charges. Whereas in India, the best of contract is one full day, 24 hours. Most contracts, it is 48 hours. Now, customers are working out such adverse contract that they want 48 hours without any detention. But if truck comes 1 hour late, there is a 5,000 rupees penalty. But if it is detained for 1 day, the detention is 500 rupees. Now, when you make all these distorted contracts, the burden will be on the cost. So essentially, whether this logistics cost is increasing because of tolls and taxes, inefficiencies in the factories, unless you make a detailed study of it, you can keep on blaming somebody. And I also want to tell you, only 30% of this logistics cost is actual transportation cost. 70% is everything else.
Thank you for watching. See you on next Monday.